Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Hello everyone. Good morning. Welcome back to science class with me. So today we are going to learn about living things. Yeah. Okay. Still same as the last week. In the last week we have learned about living things, and now let's go further about living things. And now we are going to move to the next unit about what kinds of living things are there. Okay, so let's brush up just a little. We have learned about what living things need and what can living things do. And now what kinds of living things are there? Okay, what kinds? Apa saja macam-macam of living things are there yang ada di sekitar kita? Okay, so let's see about the groups of living things. Don't forget, living things have four groups. Jadi living things itu ada empat kelompok. Animals, yeah, and then plants, fungi, and bacteria. Okay, so let's go further. And please open your pupils book first. And for activity book, just for your homework. Okay, so you have to focus to your pupils book. Okay, so everybody, living things have four groups. The first, animals, hewan, and the second, plants, tumbuhan, and the third, fungi, and the fourth, bacteria. Okay, so four living things group. Don't forget. Okay, so let's learn about each of the groups. Okay, the first, animal. Animal is hewan, yeah, hewan-hewanan. Okay, animals come in different shapes and sizes. They have parts such as heads, arms, and then wings, fins, legs, and tail. Okay, jadi animals, hewan, itu dia memiliki shapes. Shapes is bentuk. And sizes, ukuran, memiliki bentuk dan ukuran yang berbeda. For example, the elephant, and then the giraffe, and then what's again, and cat and dog are, yes, they are animals, and they have different shapes and sizes. Jadi, hewan-hewan memiliki ukuran dan bentuk tubuh yang berbeda-beda. Ada yang kecil, ada yang besar, like that. Okay, okay. They have parts such as heads, arms. Jadi mereka memiliki bagian-bagian tubuh yang dinamakan heads, kepala, arms, lengan, wings, sayap, fins, sirip, legs, kaki, and tail, ekor. Okay, ada animals yang punya tail and some animals don't have tail. Jadi ada beberapa hewan yang punya ekor, ada juga yang tidak punya ekor, like this. Okay, so animal have shapes and sizes. It's different. Okay, so let's see. Okay, for example, parts of a bird. Let's see about parts of a bird, bagian-bagian dari tubuh bird, burung. Okay, so bird have wings. Jadi bird, burung, rata-rata memiliki wings. Wings, sayap, ya. Baik itu burung yang bisa terbang. For example, eagle, elang, and then burung yang tidak bisa terbang. For example, penguin, ya, penguin tidak bisa terbang. But penguin still have wings. Tetap, semua burung punya wings, punya sayap, like this. Okay, next, head, kepala, and two legs, kaki, ya. Okay, and what's the next? Tail, of course. Tail is ekor. Yeah, the all of the bird have tail. Okay, so for this is the example of the bird. Yeah. Okay, next. So let's compare to fish. Yeah, kita bandingkan dengan fish. Okay, so fish same as bird, fish have head, and then fins, but fish have fins. Jadi berbeda dengan bird, fish punya sirip, fin. This is fins. The name is fin. Okay, so of course the fish have tail, yeah. Fish juga punya ekor. And then so this human going to human is going to grouping into animals. Jadi human kita kelompokkan atau kita akan kelompokkan menjadi kelompok hewan-hewanan. Okay. Okay, so let's see. Okay, so human have two legs and then we have two arms. And of course, we have head. Okay, the common parts of our body, of animal's body, are head, arms, and legs. Just three, ya. Jadi, ciri-ciri atau bagian-bagian tubuh, ya, of animals, just three. In the common, secara umum. Okay, head, arms, and legs. Okay, next. Okay, so everybody, animals move in different ways, such as crawling. Jadi, hewan juga bisa bergerak dengan cara yang berbeda-beda. For example, crawling. Crawling is merayap. Yeah, for example, snake, and then cockroach, and what again? Crocodile. Okay, crocodile. Next, flying, terbang. Yeah, animals move, for example, flying, terbang. Butterfly and then bird and the other animals. Okay, next, hopping. Jadi ada beberapa hewan juga yang bergerak dengan cara melompat, hopping, ya. For example, kangaroo and rabbit, kelinci, like that. Okay, so running or swimming. Ada yang berlari dan berenang. For running, for example, is cheetah and then lion and what again? Tiger. For swimming, for example, fish, dolphin, and whale, and the other animals, yeah, and fish, all of the fish. Okay, next. Okay, come in different shapes and sizes, same as animal. Jadi, plants juga memiliki shape, bentuk, and sizes, ukuran yang berbeda-beda, yeah. For example, the grass, yeah, rumput, and then the mango tree, yeah, pohon mangga. So, mango tree and the grass are plants, but they have different shapes and size. Okay, for example, mango tree have a big what? Yes, have a big tree, yeah. But for grass, they have small shapes and sizes of them, yeah. Okay, contohnya untuk pohon mangga memiliki ukuran tubuh yang besar, but untuk grass, rumput-rumputan, rata-rata ukurannya kecil-kecil. Okay, but they are plants, tapi mereka sama-sama plants, tumbuhan. Okay, like this, yeah, shapes and sizes. Okay, next. Okay, the common parts of them are leaves, daun, yeah. Leaves is daun, daun-daunnya banyak, leaves, ya. Yeah. And then stems, batang, stem is batang. And the third is roots, akar, ya. Yeah. So this is the common parts of the plants. Ini adalah parts, bagian secara umum dari tumbuhan. Okay, leaves, stems, and roots, just three, same as animals. Okay, next. Okay, so everybody, the plants have two groups. The first group is flowering plants and the second group is non-flowering plants. Jadi, plants tumbuhan mempunyai dua jenis. The first, flowering plants, tumbuhan yang berbunga. Tumbuhan berbunga, ya. Yeah? And then non-flowering plants, tumbuhan yang tidak berbunga. Okay. Flowering plants have flowers and fruit. Untuk flowering plants memiliki bunga dan buah. Okay, so it's different from non-flowering plants. Non-flowering plants do not have flowers and fruit. non and do not. Okay, like this. Okay, next. Okay, we are going to learn about flowering plants first. Flowering plants. Okay, so everybody, for example, orange tree. Orange tree. The parts of orange tree are leaves, stems, yeah, leaves, stems, roots. But for flowering plants, it's so special, yeah. Karena, because flowering plants have flower and fruits. You can see this, fruits, ada buahnya. Untuk flowering plants, dia sangat unik, ya. Sangat khusus, karena dia memiliki fruits, buah, buah yang berasal dari flowers, bunga, ya. So, sepanjang hidupnya, ya, this tree, flowering plants, always produce flower and fruits. But so it's different from non-flowering plants. Okay, non-flowering plants have not ever given or reproduced fruit and flower like that. Okay, so let's see. Okay, so this for your information. The fruits can reproduce from the flower. Jadi buah itu dia dihasilkan dari adanya penyerbukan bunga. Tanpa adanya bunga, maka di dalam tanaman itu tidak akan terbentuk buah. Okay, like this. So the flower is very important. Very important. Okay. Next. The second type is non-flowering plants. So let's go further about non-flowering plants. Okay, so for non-flowering plants, they have say parts of body same as usual. Yeah, they have stems and then they have leaves, and so it's important parts they have roots. Jadi untuk non-flowering plants memiliki bagian-bagian yang sama seperti bagian tumbuhan secara umum, ya. They don't have fruits and what again? Fruits and flower. Okay, like that, yeah. For example, so this is what is beringin, ya. Beringin tree, pohon beringin, ya. Pohon beringin cannot give oleifrogous flower and fruits. Okay. Okay, next, the third group is fungi. Fungi, jamur-jamuran. Okay, the first group is animal. The second group is plants. Plants have two types, flowering and non-flowering plants. And then the second is fungi. Okay, fungi. Let's move to fungi, everybody. Fungi may look like plants. Jadi, fungi itu bisa jadi terlihat seperti plants, tumbuhan. But, fungi is not plants. Fungi are not plants. Jadi fungi itu bukan tumbuh-tumbuhan. Jamur bukan tumbuh-tumbuhan. Okay, fungi is fungi. Jamur adalah jamur. Okay, it's different from plants or animal or bacteria. Okay. So, but they don't have leaves. Sorry, untitled leaves, stems and roots. Karena fungi tidak memiliki daun, batang ataupun akar. So, we cannot call them plants, because the fungi do not have leaves, stems, or roots. Okay, sorry, I'm typo again. Okay, next. They take in food from living things, for example, trees, or dead things, for example, rotting logs. Okay, jadi fungi take in food, mendapatkan makanannya from living things, dari makhluk hidup yang lain. For example, contohnya dari pohon yang masih hidup ataupun pohon yang sudah mati, or dead things, or rotting logs, atau pohon-pohon yang sudah tumbang. Okay, like that. Okay, next. Okay, some fungi parasite. Jadi ada beberapa fungi yang dia itu parasit, ya, yang hidup pada inangnya, pada makhluk hidup yang lain. Okay. Okay, so let's go further about different kinds of fungi. Okay, we have three kinds of fungi. Ya, let's go further. Ada tiga macam dari fungi. The first, mushrooms. Mushrooms is jamur-jamuran. Ya, we can see mushroom by our night eyes. Kita bisa melihat mushroom, jenis mushroom, ya, dengan mata kita sendiri tanpa bantuan microscope or loop or anything else. Ya, jadi mushroom itu adalah jamur-jamuran secara umum. Ya, jamur yang kita makan and then jamur yang hidup di pohon, jamur yang besar-besar yang bisa kita lihat dengan mata kita sendiri, like that. Ya. We can call them mushrooms. Okay. The second type is mold. Mold is, you know, jamur pelapuk, ya. Yeah. Mold is jamur pelapuk. For example, do you know tempeh? Yeah, we can see the white spot on tempeh. Kita lihat seperti papas, ya, yeah, on tempeh, di atas tempeh. So, we can call them mold. Kita sebut itu sebagai mold, ya. Yeah. Tempeh akan jadi with mold, with yeast, ya, yeah, dengan jamur. Okay, so for example, when you have bird or bread at your home, and then your bread is expired, yeah, has expired, you can see there is mold live on the bread. Ya, lama-lama kita lihat breadnya, nanti akan muncul putih-putih, abu-abu di atas breadnya. Okay, so we can call the mold. Ya, mereka itu adalah fungi, jamur-jamuran. Tapi kita sebut sebagai mold, not mushroom, mold. Ya, okay, biasanya mold tumbuhnya di makanan-makanan yang sudah basi. Okay, like that. It's expired. Okay, next. The third type is yeast. Yeast in bahasa Indonesia is ragi. Ya, ragi. Okay, maybe you can ask to your mother, what is ragi? Okay, because your mother... use ragi or yeast to make bread and then to make what again? Yogurt, yeah, yogurt and so anything else, cake and cookies. Yeah, you can use them. Okay, so for yeast, yeast are tiny. Yeast itu benar-benar kecil. We need microscope. Kita butuh alat yang namanya mikroskop to see them, untuk melihat bentuk dan ukuran mereka. Okay, so this is yeast. We can see yeast if we use microscope. Okay, next. Okay, for example, produk yang menggunakan ragi atau yeast, ya, contohnya yogurt. Do you know yogurt? Okay, I like yogurt. Okay, so yogurt, some of yogurts use yeast. Jadi ada beberapa yogurt yang menggunakan yeast. Ada juga beberapa yogurt yang menggunakan bakteri, ya. So, jadi bakteri atau yeast yang digunakan yang masuk ke tubuh kita adalah yeast atau bakteri baik. Ya, it's healthy. It's so healthy for us. Okay, like that everybody. Next. Okay. So, the fourth group is bacteria. Okay, the first group is animal, the second plants, the third fungi, and the fourth bacteria. Bakteri. Bacteria, bakteri, ya, bakteri. So you can see this. This is a petri dish, cawan petri yang berisi bakteria, yang berisi koloni-koloni atau kumpulan dari bakteri. Okay, we cannot see bacteria without microscope. Kita tidak bisa melihat bentuk dan ukuran bakteri tanpa microscope. Ya, yeah. But we can see just colony, koloni, hanya kumpulannya saja, like this. We use or we need a microscope to see them. Okay, bacteria are tiny living things, same as yeast. Okay, we need microscope to see them. Tiny, tiny is sangat kecil. Small is kecil, tiny sangat sangat kecil. Okay, some bacteria are harmful and can make us sick. Jadi ada beberapa bakteri yang berbahaya yang buat kita manusia sakit, ya. However, many bacteria are harmless. Tetapi ada beberapa bakteri yang tidak berbahaya. Some are even useful. Dan beberapanya juga sangat berguna untuk kehidupan manusia. For example, okay, do you know what is it? Like a vaccine. So what's that? Some medicine. Jadi ada beberapa obat ya yang menggunakan bakteri untuk mengobati penyakit manusia. For example, antibiotik ya. Antibiotik itu adalah bakteri yang dilemahkan untuk membunuh bakteri lain yang jahat. Okay. For example like that. And then for example, maybe we can use bacteria to make yogurt. Yeah, yogurt bisa kita buat dengan bacteria or yeast. And then so what again? Oh, in our colon, jadi di usus besar kita, ya, ada namanya bakteri E. coli, Escherichia coli. So this is a harmless bacteria. Ya, ini adalah bakteri yang tidak berbahaya yang dibutuhkan untuk membusukkan sisa-sisa makanan yang telah kita makan, yang telah kita cerna. Okay, I like that. Okay, understand ya. Jadi kita butuh bakteri ini untuk tetap hidup di usus kita. Okay, like that. Okay, next. Next, bacteria can be. Okay, so let's see about shapes and size of bacteria. There are three shapes. Okay, the first round bacteria, bakteri yang bentuknya rounded, bulat ya, bulat-bulat. You can see this. Okay, ini gambar dari microscope, from microscope. Okay, so for example, we can find round bacteria on human skin. Jadi di kulit kita, kita bisa menemukan round bacteria, bakteri yang bentuknya bulat-bulat. Okay, next, long and thin bacteria in water. Long and thin. Panjang dan thin, tipis ya, bacteria in water. Kita bisa temukan bakteri yang bentuknya long and thin in water, di dalam air. You can see this. Okay, in science, we can call them bacill, long and thin, same as bacill, ya, bacill. Okay, next. Next shape, coil-shaped bacteria in cow's stomach. Jadi, coil-shaped. Bentuknya itu seperti memutar, ya, spiral. Kita bisa temukan these shapes of bacteria in a cow's stomach, di perutnya cows, sapi. Yeah. So this is so useful from cows. Jadi bakteri ini bisa sangat berguna bagi sapi, ya. Yeah. Because the gastrointestinal of cows, jadi lambungnya sapi, ya. Yeah, cows is different from human. Jadi lambungnya sapi itu berbeda dengan lambungnya manusia. So, jadi sapi butuh bantuan dari bakteri-bakteri lain atau enzim lain untuk mencerna makanan yang dia makan every day like this. Because cows eat grass every day. Yeah. Okay, next. Okay, let's preview. Let's preview before we call you one by one. Okay, so we have learned about living things. Living things have four groups: animal, plants, fungi, and bacteria. For animals, we have such parts of our body, the common head, arms, and legs. For plants, plants have two types: flowering plants and non-flowering plants. And the third, fungi have three kinds of fungi: mushrooms, mold, and yeast. And then bacteria, we have learned about bacteria. Bacteria have three shapes, yeah. So actually bacteria have the other shapes. Jadi sebetulnya bakteri itu punya bentuk yang bermacam-macam lagi. But we have learned just three types, yeah: coil shaped, and then rounded, and long and thin bacteria. Okay, just like that. Okay, so I have some question for you. I have 11 questions, and now it's time to call you. Okay, who's the first? The first is, who's that? Okay, the first is Yura and Pahri. I'll try to call Yura first. Okay, I'm calling Yura. Okay. Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh, Yura. Okay, Yura, we meet again, and now I want to call Fahri, yeah, to join with us. Fahri, wait. Fahri, okay. Fahri, come join with us. Okay, Yura, what are you doing? Are you studying? Are you watching our lessons? I have 11 questions. Oh, this Fahri. Assalamualaikum, Fahri. Assalamualaikum, Fahri. Can you hear me, Fahri? Okay, Fahri and Yura, please say salam each other. Say salam each other. Very good boys. Okay, Yura, for number one, please, can you read this number one and please answer? Okay, groups of living thing. Mention. Animals, plants, bacteria. Very good. It's easy. Mashallah. Barakallahu fiik. Okay, enough. Yeah. Thank you very much. And now, Fahri, it's your turn. Okay, Fahri, please read number two and then what is this? And then answer number two. Give each. Okay, give each one example of four living things group. Yura said animals, plants, fungi, and bacteria. Okay, for animal, what is example? Yes, for animal. Only one example, only one. Oh, animals, plants, fungi, and bacteria, all of them. Yes, one. One by one. Yes. Up to you. And then if Fahri need help, yes. Okay, it's easy. Berikan contohnya yang termasuk ke dalam kelompok hewan-hewanan. Maybe you can say bird or fish or human or what again? A cat. Okay, so what's that?
Fish.
Very good. Fish. And give me example about plants. Plants. Okay. Oh, what's that? Okay. It's okay. And then fungi. Can you give me example of the fungi? Maybe you can help Fahri. What of them? Yeah. Oh, okay. It's okay. Okay. Fungi. Maybe you can mention the kinds of fungi. There are mushrooms, mold, and yeast. Oh, mushrooms. Very good, very good. Mushroom. Okay, the last one. Bacteria, bacteria. You can mention the shape. Maybe one of three shape or bacteria. Okay, maybe Fahri can mention one of three of kinds or what is it? Shape of bacteria. Round, lengthen, and coil shape. So which one do you want? Okay, coil shape. It's okay, coil shape. Okay, it's easy, right, boys? Okay, so boys, I think enough. I'll call two students again. After you, I'll call Roji and Shafiq. Roji and Shafiq. Okay, boys. So far, any question for me? Yura and Fahri, do you have question for teacher? No, not. Okay, Yura, not. How about you? Oh, not again. Okay, so I think enough. See you soon, everybody. Bye-bye. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Okay. Oh, what's question? Okay, Fahri, what is question? Oh no, Yura, do you have question? Okay, Yura. Okay, Yura, what is your question? Yes, how? How family produce? Okay. Wait. I can hear you. Wait. For Fahri, Fahri, can you off your video? Yeah. Thank you for Fahri. Yeah. If Fahri don't have tuition. Okay, Fahri. Okay, for Fahri. See you soon. Assalamualaikum, Fahri. Okay, wait, Yura, wait. Assalamualaikum, Fahri. Okay, bye. Okay, Yura. Okay, please repeat your question. How?
How mushroom reproduce?
Mushroom reproduce. Okay, very good. Very good. Okay, so you know. Some of plants reproduce by seeds, right? Okay, but it's different from mushroom. Mushroom can reproduce by their spore. Yeah, jadi untuk fungi or mushroom, dia reproduksinya dengan spora namanya. Spore. Like this, you can see. Spore, you can see this. Okay. Spore, okay, or spora in bahasa Indonesia. Okay, you can see this. Spora. Okay, teacher wants to explain about spora. Okay, do you know? Okay, jadi so spora itu bentuknya seperti biji ya, tapi itu bukan biji. Jadi bulat-bulat kecil, tapi bisa dilihat hanya dengan mikroskop, di bawah mikroskop. Oke, okay, jadi bentuknya itu seperti tepung, ya, kalau di tangan. Tapi kalau misalkan Yura wants to look shape and size about spore, you can use or you need microscope to see them. Oke, okay. Jadi spora itu adanya di like this. Spora itu adanya di bawah tudung, ya, tudung atau payung dari jamurnya. You can see, I need mushroom. Nah, ya, di bawah ini ada, okay, nah, di sini sporanya ada di sini, ya. Di sini ada spora di sini, like this, okay? Okay, so now you understand about refugees of mushroom?
Yes.
Masya Allah, very good. Okay, thanks for your question, Yura. Any question again?
Yes.
Okay, so thanks for asking me, Yira. Okay, very good. Insyaallah barakallahu fiik and barakallahu fiikum for Fahri and Yura. Yeah. Okay, so Yura, see you soon. Bye bye. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Bye. Okay. Okay, thanks for Fahri and Yura. Okay, so it's hard effort, Fahri, for answer for number 2. Very good. I appreciate your answer. And for Yura, thanks for your question about the repurchase of mushroom. Okay. Okay, next number 3 and number 4, I'll call Bozi and Shafiq. Now, I'll call Bozi and Shafiq. Okay, we are waiting for this. You mentioned 3 main parts of human, animal, and plants. And then number 4, are plants and fungi same? Okay, the first is Gozi and the second is Shafiq. Okay, hello, assalamualaikum Gozi. Oh, okay, we meet again. So I'll call Shafiq to join with us. Okay, wait. Wait a second. Shafiq. Okay, let Shafiq join with us. Ah, okay, we are waiting for Shafiq and Rosie. So do you understand about our lesson?
Yes.
Okay, so it's Shafiq. Assalamualaikum Shafiq. Assalamualaikum Shafiq. Where is Shafiq? Okay, I'll call again. Okay, we are waiting for Shafiq and Gozi. I have question about our lesson. Yeah. Okay, so what's happened? Oh, okay, assalamualaikum Shafiq. Assalamualaikum Shafiq, can you hear me? Okay, very good. Okay, so Shafiq and Gozi, let's salam, say salam each other.
Hello,
Gozi. Hello, Gozi. Assalamualaikum.
Hello,
Shafiq.
Assalamualaikum.
How are you, Gozi? Okay, very good voice. Okay, mashallah. Very good, very good. Very good voice. Okay. So Shafiq and Rosie, yeah, I have question about our lesson in this morning, and start from Rosie. So Rosie, please read the question and answer the question number 3. Mention. Yes. And plants. Okay, so Rosie, mention 3 main parts of human or animals and plants. Coba sebutkan bagian-bagian tubuh secara umum ya dari human atau animals and plants, tumbuhan. Okay, 3, just 3. For human, yeah, for human. Yes, what's that? Yes, heads. Okay. Head, arms, and legs. Very good. How about plants? Tumbuhan. Mention 3 parts. Leaves. Okay, stems and roots. MashaAllah, very good. Very good, Gozi. Yeah, correct. And now number 4 is Shafiq's turn. Please, Shafiq, read the question number 4. You can see? You can see this.
Okay.
are plants. Yeah. Okay, please read the question number 4. Okay, this is number 4. Shafiq, please read. Okay, can you see this? On the video. Yes. Plants and fungi. Okay. Are plants and fungi same? Apakah plants tumbuhan dan fungi jamur itu sama? Yes or no? Not. Why? Kenapa? Why the plants and fungi are different? Why? Okay. Fungi cannot make. Own food. And then what again? Can you tell me again? Okay. And then fungi. Do fungi have leaves, stems, and roots same as plants? Apakah menurut Syafiq fungi itu punya leaves, down, stems, or root? No, but okay. So the reason, the second reason, because fungi have not leaves, stems, and roots. Very good. Because fungi cannot make their own food, and then fungi don't have leaves, stems, and roots. Very good. MashaAllah, barakallahu fikum, Razi and Syafiq. Yeah. Okay. Very good. Okay, so boys, I see enough. See you soon. Bye bye. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Okay. Thanks for Razi and Syafiq. And now for number 5 and 6, I'll try to call Fatima and Ayesha. Okay, Fatima and Aisha. Okay, I'm calling Fatima first. Okay, we are waiting for. Okay. Okay. Hello, Fatima. Okay. Assalamualaikum, Fatima. Okay. Hello. Assalamualaikum, Fatima. Okay, assalamualaikum Ayesha.
Waalaikumsalam.
Okay, so let's go. Say salam each other, both of you. Okay, Ayesha said, assalamualaikum Fatima. Okay. Oh, very good. Very good girls. Okay, I'm done. Okay, finish, yeah, I've done, yeah. Okay, so Fatima and Ayesha, I have some questions for Fatima and Ayesha, yeah. Fatima first for number 5, and then Ayesha number 6, Yeah. Okay. So go on, Fatima, read the question and then answer your questions. Okay. Fatima can see on the video. This is Fatima, number 5. Okay. Read, please. Yes. Mention. Yes, 2. Okay, of lamps. Okay. Okay, so do you understand about the question? Okay, mention 2 types of lamps. Coba sebutkan 2 tipe lamps yang sudah kita pelajari. Apa saja? What's that? Fatima. Okay, what's that? There are 2 types of lamps. Okay, so what's that? Okay. There are the plants don't have root and the plants have roots. So what is the name? The plant have that the plant have fruits. Plants yang ada buahnya. Tumbuhan yang ada buahnya yang bisa menghasilkan buah. We can call blah 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 plants. What's that? Yes. Okay, very good. Flowering plants. And then the second type is. Non-flowering plants and okay, non-flowering plants, yeah, those, okay, enough for Fatima, yeah. 2 types of plants, flowering plants and non-flowering plants. And then, Aisha, it's your turn for number 6, Aisha. Okay, you can read this. Mention. Okay, please mention parts of flowering plants. Coba sebutkan bagian-bagian dari tumbuhan yang berbunga. What's that? Leaves, very good. Roots. Stems, very good. What again? Flower. And what's the last? What is the last? Okay, fruit, yeah, Masya Allah, very good, it's easy, right? Okay, very good, girls. Okay, Masya Allah, Barakallahu Fikum, girls, Aisha and Fatima, yeah. Okay, so, because we have 11 minutes more left, I'll call Fatin and Afifah, yeah. Okay, so, stay tuned on YouTube, girls. See you soon, bye-bye. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Okay. Thank you. Thanks for Fatima and Aisha. Very good. Okay, now I'll try to call Afifa and Fatin. Okay, let's review. Okay, we have more questions about mention parts of non-flowering plants and mention 3 kinds of fungi, and then mention 3 shapes of bacteria. Okay, we have 10 minutes more left. Okay, we are waiting for Afifah. Okay, hello, assalamualaikum Afifah. Thank you. Hey. Assalamualaikum Afifah. Okay, repeat again, yeah. Okay, Afifah, so to the point, yeah, because we have 9 minutes more left. Afifah, I have question about our lesson in this morning, and let's read the question number 7 and answer your question. Okay, go on. Mention. Okay, wait, it's okay. Or maybe I have to read the question for you girls. Hello. Okay, hello, assalamualaikum Fatin. Assalamualaikum Fatin. Okay, Fatin and Afifah, say salam each other please. Okay, very good. Okay, now enough, yeah. Okay, for number 7, I'll read the question for Afifah, and number 8, I'll read the question for Fatin, yeah. So Afifah first. Okay, so Afifah, number 7, mention parts of non-flowering plants. Coba sebutkan bagian-bagian dari non-flowering plants. Yeah, parts of body of non-flowering plants. What's that, Afifah? Okay, leaves. Okay, leaves, and then? Okay, very good. Stems and roots, easy. Very good, correct, yeah. And now, Fatin, it's your turn. Mention 3 kinds of fungi. Mention 3 kinds of fungi. Ada 3 macam dari fungi. So what's that? Apa saja? Yes. Mushroom. Okay, very good. What's the next? The first word, mold. Okay, the last one. Okay, the last one. The first alphabet is Y. What's that? That we need microscope to see them. Yang kita butuh mikroskop untuk melihat jamurnya. What's that? Yes. Okay, yes. Yeah. You can read yes. Very good. Very good. Very good. Yeah. Okay, so enough. Masya Allah, barakallahu fikum for Fatin and Afifah. Very good answer. Yeah. Okay, because we have 6 minutes more left. I'll call Fadil and Ali after Afifah and Fatin. Okay? Yeah? Okay, so thank you very much. Stay tuned on YouTube. 5 minutes more left. Bye-bye. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Okay. Okay, now I'll try to call Fadil first. Sorry. Fadil. Okay, hello, assalamualaikum Fadil. Okay, we meet again Fadil. Okay, very good. Okay, so Fadil, I have question for Fadil. Okay, Fadil, for number 9, please mention 3 shapes of bacteria. Can you mention it? 3 shapes of bacteria.
Coil.
Coil. Coil what?
Coil, circle, and
Okay, coil, circle, circle, really? Coil shape, circle. Okay, circle or round and. Okay. Long and thin.
Long and thin shape.
Oh, okay, very good. Shape. Yeah. Okay, so we can find coil shaped in where is that? Coil shape. In the coil's stomach, right? Okay. How about circle? Okay, how about circle and round? We can find circle and round bacteria on our
human skin.
Okay, human skin and long and thin shape in the wool, the water. Okay, very good. It's easy, right? Okay, it's correct. Inshallah, barakallahu fik. Yeah. Thank you for Fadil. And we have 3 minutes more left. I'll try to call Ali after you, and then I'll try to call Farel. Okay, stay tuned on YouTube. 2 minutes more left. Bye bye. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Bye. Okay, now I'll try to call Ali. Ali, yeah. Okay, so for number 10 for Ali and number 11 for Farel. Number 10, where we can find the kinds of bacteria? And then di mana saja kita bisa menemukan macam-macam bakteri? Yeah, so last time Fadil have mentioned about the place where we can find of the bacteria coil shape in blah blah blah, and then so long and thin in blah blah blah, and round bacteria in blah blah blah, like this. And for number 11, why we cannot see yeast and bacteria by our naked eyes? Kenapa kita tidak bisa melihat yeast, ya, ragi, and bacteria by our naked eyes? Okay, so now I'll try to call Farel. Yeah, naked eyes. What we can use to see them? Kenapa kita tidak bisa melihat ragi dan beberapa bakteri dengan mata kita? Hello, assalamualaikum Farel.
Assalamualaikum.
Okay, so Farel. To the point, yeah. Farel, why we cannot see yeast and bacteria by our naked eyes? Kenapa kita tidak bisa melihat bakteri dengan mata kita sendiri secara langsung? Why? Kenapa? Because the bacteria is okay, what is kecil in English? Farel, where are you? Go on. Okay, I'm talking to you. Because it's tiny, karena sangat kecil. So, what can we use to see them? Kira-kira kita bisa menggunakan benda apa untuk bisa melihat bakteri atau yeast yang sangat kecil? So, we can use, what is that? Okay, apa namanya? What is this?
Microscope.
Okay, microscope, yeah. Okay, please remember about that. Okay, so, Farel, I just want to ask you about this, only this, because our time is up. And now I'll try to call Ali again. See you, bye bye. Yeah, see you later. I want to call you again to read your Iqra, Farel. Okay? Okay? Okay, very good. Please prepare your Iqra and prepare yourself. Okay, bye bye. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Bye.
Okay, I'll try to call Ali now. I cannot hear by my phone. Okay, our time is up. One student again, I call Ali. Okay, so maybe I cannot call Ali. I have called Ali 3 times. Okay, so for 10, where we can find the kinds of bacteria, all of you please, and start question number 10 at your home, each all of you.